The information I'm about to give you is classified as a matter of state security. At approximately 1100 hours local time, enemies of the Russian people detonated a nuclear weapon at the Romskino oil fields. Hundreds are feared dead. And one of our country's major energy production centers has been completely destroyed. It is undeniable that the liberal pro-Western policies of President Kazgazev's government is at least partly to blame for this catastrophe. That is why a group of patriotic citizens, led by noted statesman Alexander Treskiev and supported by senior members of the military, have forced President Kazgazev to step down and assume control of the government for the duration of the present emergency. I have informed President Treskiev that Spetsgruppe Medved will find the perpetrators of this atrocity and make them pay for what they've done. We've received intelligence indicating that the separatist leaders are gathering tonight for a high-level meeting. No doubt to discuss strategy in the wake of the attack. We will fill the air with hunter-killer drones. And when the bastards show their faces, we'll put a missile right between their eyes. All units, this is General Morganov. The separatists are on the move. Proceed to your assigned area and locate your target vehicle. You will use your RF intercept gear to pick up any wireless transmissions from the vehicle. The separatist communications are encrypted, but we can use the signals themselves to identify the enemy leaders. Then we follow them and see where they lead us.
Target identified. Good work, Sokol. Stay on them and wait for my signal.
Open fire!
Engage and destroy all targets marked on your tactical display. The general wants the whole place sterilized.
Damn it to hell, we've got to tell the Americans what happened to Dmitry Ivanovich, or millions of people are going to die. Tereskayev and his cronies have ordered the communications blackout. Right now, Russia is completely cut off from the outside world. The only way to get the word out is to carry it to the Americans ourselves. There are people in the U.S. military who know me. I may be able to get a short message to them, but we're going to need a plane. Morganov is about to start cleaning up loose ends. For right now, continue the mission as though nothing has happened. Then copy the audio file and meet me at Hangar 4. There's a great deal riding on this, Dmitry Ivanovich. Don't let me down.
Done. Justice for the lives lost at Romeshkino. Justice for our brothers who died at Nevskaya Dam. All units return to base. Rest assured, I will inform President Tereskayev that our mission was a complete success.
Well done, Dmitry Ivanovich. This plane's unarmed, but it's fast. We'll need all the speed we can get to make it to the rendezvous point in time.
Colonel Crenshaw, this is Wolfhound. By now you are no doubt aware of the nuclear detonation at Romeshkino and the communications blackout that followed. You may also be aware that Alexander Tereskayev and a cabal of oligarchs forced President Karskazev to step down and seize power for themselves. What you do not know is that Tereskayev and his supporters created the crisis that made this coup possible. They hired former Russian soldiers to masquerade as separatists in southern Russia, and a Russian general named Vasily Morganov supplied these mercenaries with weapons meant for his own troops. Morganov also used his men to pass weapons on to Hafiz. The insurgent attacks were meant to stretch your military thin and keep you from interfering in their plans. The blast at Romeshkino was just the beginning. A second nuke has been delivered to the insurgents and is on its way to its target. I have recordings in my possession that will prove all of this, and a loyalist pilot has agreed to help deliver them to you. We'll be flying out of the country in a stolen fighter. Meet me at the coordinates provided, and be ready for a fight. General Morganov is going to come after us with everything he's got.
Make for the runway, Dmitry Ivanovich. Go! Keep going!
Let's go. I know you can hear me. Agent Drachev is with you, I assume.
I'm here, General. Despite your best efforts to the contrary.
I've heard stories about you, Voron agents. They say you're a ghost. I didn't believe them until now. When did you start to suspect me?
When I realized that one of the Dukes was missing from the train. You are the only person who could have warned the Separatists, General. It was a foolish move.
I had to improvise. Once I was ordered to recover the warhead, the mission had to succeed. Two recovered Dukes were better than nothing.
And you dragged us over those air defense units in hopes it would be shut down. You destroyed that dam and killed all those men just to shut me up. You're a cold-blooded bastard, General.
Where is the shame in that? Those men will be remembered as heroes.
And what about the people at Romashkino? What about them?
I would never have predicted such a thing to happen. Never.
Treskayev used you, General. You must see that now. He and his allies were planning to destroy Romashkino all along.
What's done is done, Drachev. It was a tragedy, a terrible tragedy, but ultimately, it will be for the good of the country. It is a pity. You want me to see it. You're both brave men. I won't insult your honor by ordering you to turn back. You doing what you believe is right. So am I. Do svidaniya, my friends.
is Medved Flight Leader. Reduce throttle and alter course to 010, or we will shoot you down. You've got nowhere left to go, Sokov. Surrender or be destroyed.
Enemy aircraft in close pursuit. Can anyone read me?
Wolfhound, this is Mustang Lead. We have you on our scopes at 019 or range 20 miles. Stand by.
Off your tanks.